Shifting our focus and talking about the battle for Bengal. Well, the battle lines are drawn just a few months ahead of that crucial assembly elections. Battle for Bengal is heating up. Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee is currently holding a rally in Purulia. Interestingly, Satabdi Roy, who was recently placated by an elevation in the party, is also present along with Didi. Suvendu Adhikari is also holding a rally in Khejuri, while TMC is slated to hold a counter rally in Kolkata in a while. In a big announcement on Monday, Mamata said that she wants to contest from Nandigram, Suvendu Adhikari's passion. On the other hand, Suvendu Adhikari also threw an open dare to Mamata Banerjee, saying if she doesn't lose Nandigram by over 500,000 votes, he will quit politics. Listen it.
আমি হয়তো ইলেকশনের সময় অত টাইম দিতে পারবো না, কারণ আমাকে তো 294টা সিটে লড়তে হবে। সেই জন্য আপনারা কিন্তু কাজটা করে দেবেন, কিন্তু তারপরে যা কাজ আমি সব করে দেব, ঠিক আছে? তাহলে এটা আমার ইচ্ছা হয়েছে, আমার মনোবাসনা। ভবানীপুরকেও আমি নেগলেক্ট করছি না, ভবানীপুরেও আমি ভালো প্রার্থী দেবো, ওটাও আমার ভালোবাসার জায়গা। বক্সিকে বলবো নন্দীগ্রামে আমার নামটা যেন থাকে।
আজকে সন্ধ্যাবেলা ঘড়িতে টাইম দিয়ে ডেট দিয়ে আপনারা লিখে রাখুন, 500,000 ভোটে যদি মাননীয়াকে হারাতে না পারি আমি রাজনীতি ছেড়ে দেব, আমি রাজনীতি ছেড়ে দেব, আপনি লিখে রাখুন।
Here are some developments which are being reported from Bengal. There are clashes between BJP and TMC supporters in Khejuri, East Midnapur, ahead of Suvendu Adhikari's public meeting. That unfortunate violent nature of Bengal politics continues. Multiple times, at multiple occasions, we have seen how TMC and BJP workers have clashed. There was an attack on JP Nadda's convoy as well that kicked off a political storm. My colleague Shogato joining us live, getting us more details on that story. Shogato, over to you. The details you're picking up.
Well, as far as the clashes in Khejuri are concerned, it has happened. It is still going on at this point in time. We are getting information from the ground that, the Shivendu Adhikari's rally in Khejuri, which was planned as a counter to Mamata Banerjee's meeting in Nandigram yesterday. And there is also a Trinamool Congress rally, which is also a public meeting, rather, which has been planned in that same area where Shivendu Adhikari is supposed to hold his public meeting in a short while from now. And there were rallies that were taken out by both sides and were headed for their respective public meeting zones. But when two such rallies came face to face in Khejuri, violence broke out. Workers from both sides now alleging that the other side had in fact provoked the violence that is currently going on, and with sticks and bricks and stones they have heard, they have lashed on each other, and the clashes are going on. Police, we are told, are finding it very, very difficult to contain the tension that currently prevails in that zone. It's almost like a battlefield in Khejuri. Remember, during the Nandigram movement back in 2007-2008, Khejuri played a very, very vital role because it is right adjacent to Nandigram, it was considered to be the base of the CPIM, the left, from where the Trinamool Congress and the anti-land grab movement supporters alleged that attacks were launched on Nandigram from the Khejuri base, where CPM was holding dominance in that region. So Khejuri has witnessed prior violence back in 2007. 2007, 2008, and now in the run-up to the 2021 polls, we can see once again, you know, violence erupting, this time obviously between the Trinamool Congress and the BJP, and the police are finding it difficult to contain.
All right, Saugato, getting us all the very important details on that story. Meanwhile, a lot of political reactions lined up on the story. Listen up.
देखिए नंदीग्राम के बारे में शुभेंदु अधिकारी से ज़्यादा कौन जानता है, हार जीत क्या होने वाला ये तो उनके हाथ में ही है, इसलिए जो बोला उन्होंने शायद करके भी दिखा देंगे। ये टीएमसी पार्टी जब तक रहेगी इस प्रकार हिंसा की राजनीति रहेगी, और भाजपा को रोकने के लिए हमला और मामला ये दोनों आधार उनके पास है, अब धीरे धीरे दोनों बेकार हो चुकी हैं। हम लोकतांत्रिक पद्धति में संविधान के आधार पर राजनीति कर रहे हैं, उसी प्रकार से भाजपा बंगाल का परिवर्तन करेंगे, और परिवर्तन जितना नज़दीक आ रहा है उनके अंदर बौखलाहट बढ़ रही है और हताश होकर इस प्रकार और काम कर रहे हैं।
ममता बनर्जी थर्ड टाइम सीएम बनने की कोशिश कर रही है, दो बार ऑलरेडी सीएम रह चुके हैं, कहीं से भी लड़ सकते हैं, लेकिन जैसे 2016 में उन्होंने दोबारा 11 के बाद लोगों को क्या कहूँ, गुमराह किया था ये कह के, लोगों के साथ खिलवाड़ किया था उनके फीलिंग्स के साथ, ये कहे कि सोच लीजिए सारे 294 सीट से ममता बनर्जी ही लड़ रही है, इस बार ऐसे कह के दिखाए, नहीं कर सकते हैं।
मैंने देखा आज कि उन्होंने कहा कि वो नंदीग्राम से चुनाव लड़ेंगी भवानीपुर के अलावा। जाहिर तौर पर मैं एक तरह से, अगर आप देखिए, आप असहमत हो सहमत हो, लेकिन ये हर कोई मानता है कि ममता बनर्जी जी के अंदर एक फाइट बैक की अद्भुत क्षमता है, और कम लोग बचे हैं जैसे हमारे यहाँ नेता प्रतिपक्षी लालू जी, जिन्होंने आंख तक नहीं दबाई इस दक्षिणपंथी अधिनायकवाद के समक्ष। तो मैं समझता हूं कि उस दृष्टिकोण से देखा जाए तो बंगाल चुनाव बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग होगा।
Now here is yet another legacy war. Politics has erupted over legacy of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. In an interesting development, Centre has declared Netaji's birthday on the 23rd of January to be celebrated as Parakram Divas every year. In a notice by the Ministry of Culture, the Centre announced that the decision has been taken to honour Netaji's indomitable spirit and selfless service to the country. On the other hand, Bengal Chief Minister already announced Netaji's birthday will be celebrated as Desh Nayak Divas and urged the central government to declare 23rd January as a national holiday.
The central government has declared 23rd January as Parakram Divas. But unlike your demand, the Trinamool Congress demand to declare 23rd January as a national holiday, that demand, it seems to have not been met. What is the Trinamool Congress's reaction to the centre's decision?
We are neither impressed nor satisfied with the centre's declaring of 23rd January as Parakram Divas. We wanted it to be named as Deshoprem Divas, and our Chief Minister wrote to the Prime Minister asking him to declare this day as a national holiday. That demand has not been met. Obviously, the central government is announcing this Parakram Divas at this time to get electoral advantages. We do not appreciate that.
काफी सालों से भारत की जनता, देश की जो साधारण नागरिक, नेताजी का जन्मदिन देश प्रेम दिवस मना रहे, तो ये जो अनाउंसमेंट हुआ है आज, ये हम लोग खुश है, मगर देश की जनता खुश है ये प्रश्न तो देश की जनता ही बता पाएगा। देश प्रेम दिवस होने से ये बहुत अप्रोप्रिएट होता नेताजी का जन्मदिन में।
So those are the reactions coming in. My colleague Pal is joining us on the broadcast, getting us more details on that story. And Pal, clearly this legacy war will continue in the public discourse as we inch closer to the assembly elections. On the 23rd of January, there must be a slew of events planned up by the BJP and the TMC.
Yes, Yes, of course. This is going to be a legacy which is going to continue. Not just this, Swami Vivekananda's, Rabindranath Tagore. All of these issues have been cropping up in the last couple of months as well. Given the fact that people do realize that, yes, this is a poll season as well. But the central government, you know, in their defense will say one thing, Anusha, that, you know, they have been working on and on for the legacy of Netaji. Ever since Narendra Modi came into power, it was Narendra Modi who took that decision to declassify the files at the request of the family. And that is where it all started. So obviously, politics will continue, and it's a matter of, you know, probably one upmanship that you see over here as well. It's Mamata Banerjee versus Prime Minister and none other over here.
All right, pal. Thank you so much for pointing out all the details for us. Now, here is an interesting bit.